In higher-level programming languages, there often isn't a distinction between linked lists and arrays. There's just a list that has the properties of both. However, questions about these two data structures are fairly common in interviews, so it's important to know the difference. Again, the main distinction is that each element stores different information. In both cases, a single element will store a value, or the actual information. So, if you have an array or linked list of numbers, the value will be a single number. If you have an array or linked list of string values, then each value will contain a string. In this case, we're just going to stick with numbers. Now, in both cases, we store one other type of information, but that type is different. In an array, we would store a number as an index. You can get the next element by querying the array for the element at index 1 in this case. Let's clear this out and focus just on linked lists for now. In a linked list, we store a reference to the next element in the list. In many languages, this will look like assigning the actual next element as a property of this element. Way down at the hardware level, your element actually has some space dedicated for it in memory. These are representing the memory locations. So in this case, the next component is actually storing the memory address of the next element, while this element is storing null because it doesn't point to anything else. The nice thing about this system is that it's pretty easy to insert and delete elements. Adding an element is going to look something like this. We really just need to change the next reference to point to the new object, and done! There's a quick trick you need to remember, though. If you delete the next reference and replace it with a new object, you'll lose your reference to this object. You should always assign your next pointer for this element before you assign your next pointer for this element, so you don't lose your reference to this one down here. Now everything looks great. Note that insertion takes constant time in this case, since you're just shifting around pointers and not iterating over every element in the list. Removing an element is going to look pretty similar, so I'm not even going to go over that now. There's also something called a doubly linked list, where you have pointers to the next element and the previous element. The rules are pretty similar for a doubly linked list, except you can traverse the list in both directions now. Again, you need to be careful not to lose references when adding or removing elements, but it's easier than performing these operations on an array.